And when we call you, please respond to us. We have extended our hand to the world. We cannot do it alone, but we believe in collaborative, cooperative relationship, because there's enough to go around, but we need to be intentional to what and how we do it. To all of the sponsors, I say thank you to you. I don't want to mention names and get in trouble, but all of you are greatly appreciated. Please, when you get an email from us about the Legacy Global Network, I ask that you please respond if you're interested to be a founding member. If you're not, it's okay. This conversation has to continue. This is a birth of something that has been nursed several years. I had the privilege of working in my motherland for 5 years in the government circle. And that was where a lot of these ideas incubated, because I felt helpless. I felt like I couldn't do much, even though in my America, I could do so much more. So that was where this breath of this idea came. And at the beginning of the year when it started, only Toby Adeshina is a witness to how this journey has started. And I'm so glad that he's one of my mentees and that he would have learned one or two things from here. So thank you. I'm not doing a closing remarks. I'm just overwhelmed and grateful to each and every one of you. And Toby, I see you haven't put time up for me because I went past 2 minutes. So I'm going to stop now and we'll switch over to the awards gala this afternoon, this evening, this night. I know some of our people are in from UAE. Some of you are already texting me that, oh, you're on. I'm so excited. You are staying up this late just to be part of this. You all really melt my heart. You know what will make it even better? When we knock on your door for those funding sources, for those ability to help our young leaders who have ideas, who have all this greatness, who we would have vetted and say, guess what? We just need your coins. We just need your paper. These are good and ready to go. We hope that you respond to us when we do that. That is the measure that we want to use for this program. It's not just another program that we are going to just say, oh, we brought people. No, it's meant to be intentional that all of us can really benefit from this. Thank you so much. So I am going to hand over to the host, if she is on yet, who will take us on this. But while I'm waiting, I don't know if she's on yet. While I'm waiting, I want to continually thank all of you. I see a lot of you on the chat. Some of you have been with us since yesterday. Oh my God, you have been with us. We're looking forward to your feedback. You are going to be part of this movement. It is a movement. It is a movement. It's a legacy building movement for results. And all of you are going to be part of what is about to unfold. I'm going to wait. Okay, yes. The hostess is here. Okay, she says she's on. All right. Kelsey Nicole Nelson, one of our celebrity in the area who works for the Washington Redskins, who also has her own show. Nicole is just one of those busy people, but she still created time out of a busy schedule. I don't even want to ask where you are now, but because I know Friday is a busy time, but I feel honored on behalf of each and every one of us. So I'm going to hand over to you and let you just take us on the journey as we move with the journey and just end the event by 4:30. And hopefully we'll get a celebrity appearance, Rosina, my sister, with Acorn. So that will fit in that right there. And he can bring us greetings. That will make us so excited. Thank you, Kelsey. Please take it away.
Yeah, thanks so much for having me. My true honor and pleasure to be here. I'm excited for this part of the ceremony. As Rumi said, we're excited because there might be a celebrity appearance, and I will keep us to 4:30 because I don't want to keep anybody over, and I'm respectful of everybody's time. But truly, 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 thank you so much for having me here. Again, my honor and pleasure. This is the type of stuff that I absolutely love doing. And so to kick things off, we're excited because I want to first introduce the chair of the awards gala, because of course, no awards gala can kick off with a fabulous chair leading things off. And he is none other than Dr. Waleni Akinbabe. And I'm so sorry if I messed up.
Dr. Wale Akinbaboye. I know, it's all good.
Better than me, Rumi. So yes, I'm so excited. So I want to acknowledge him. Is he on already? Perfect. So we have a picture of our
great. We have a picture of him and the co-chair, who is also being represented by his political officer.
Awesome. Well, thank you. A special, special thank you to them both for being just fabulous chairs of this 2020 Legacy Global Awards Gala. So I want to give them a special, special thank you. All right, so next I'll go to the next part of the award ceremony, where we're going to do an overview of the Legacy Premier Foundation from Toby Adesina. So Toby, are you on? I'll give him a second to join. Super excited to
hear. So, wait.
Okay, here.
Hi everyone, my name is Toby Adesina, and very quickly I just want to do a brief introduction of Legacy Premier Foundation. So I'll be going through a few slides, and quickly I also want to thank Dr. Remy. This has been very beautiful from day one. I mean we're going to talk afterwards, but it's been very great, and so thank you so much. Thank you to all the panelists, the moderator Kelsey, Kemi, everyone who has made this possible. This is a big, huge thank you. So I'm just going to dive in straight and talk a bit about Legacy Premier Foundation. Okay, so we are a global developmental non-profit organization committed to social, economic development, empowerment, and human capital development. So what we essentially do is three major things: human capital development, access to capital, and social economic development. So what we want to do is build wealth and economic capacity around the world, especially within underserved communities. And doing so, we have certain focus areas that we consider. Even more than what you see on your screen right now, we have advocacy, access to capital, which is one of the major things we're focusing on in this event, tech literacy, renewable energy. We have capacity development, soft skills development, business incubators, education is very important to us. Financial literacy also is at the core of what we do. We have mentorship and coaching. We have fintech program. And most importantly, what we are here for, the intergenerational bridge, which is the whole idea of everything we're doing here, to bring different generations together to be able to leverage our skills, our talents, and the opportunities that exist between us to be able to push the continent as a whole forward. So I'm just gonna go deep further. All right, so we're not just acting independently, we have a global view and a global vision in mind. And so we have certain of our initiatives aligned to the UN SDGs, that's the United Nations Sustainable Development Goals. So I'm just going to run through it really fast. We have access to funding. So these are our campaigns. For those who might be wondering what this is, these are campaigns, these are programs, these are initiatives that we're currently running. And the whole essence of what I'm doing here is to seek, you know, the involvement of our partners, for those our speakers, those abroad, the diaspora, whoever, you know, you find yourself in the capacity to support. So these are the major things. We have more, but just, you know, to summarize everything we're doing, these are programs that we want to focus on, and by, you know, your involvement and partnership, we want to be able to pull them through coming next year, even not all, but most of it. So we have access to funding for Black businesses, that's ETIN and SDG 8 and 9. We have Legacy Renewable Energy Project for underserved communities and communities that are not reached. We have that under SDGs 7, 9, and 11. We have the Arise Global Internship Program, but those who are just getting out of colleges and those who want to experience, you know, high professional settings to set them up for, you know, development and capacity building. So that's ETIN, SDGs 8. We have Legacy Farm to Wealth Initiative. So this is our agri initiative for those who are passionate about agriculture. We have something in this line that can help, you know, especially farmers in Africa and those included in even the agri-tech business. So we have SDGs 1. 2, 8, 9, and 11. We have the Legacy Financial Literacy Program. This is at the core of what we do, like I've mentioned, and we can see the goals that are involved. We have the Minority Tech Initiative. One of the things we also want to do, considering the fact that the world is going into a digital future. So we want to be able to position our future leaders by, you know, catching them young and training them in the necessary tech skills they need to be competitive and stay relevant in the future. So we have the Legacy Courses Coaching for Women. This is really huge. Women are the center of what we do, and I mean, Dr. Ramey will come later to take this away, so I'm just going to run really fast. We also have Passionomics Maryland, and these, like I said earlier, are our major focus. There are more, but This one's our major focus of what we're going to be doing basically last year. And once again, I'm seeking the support of our speakers. You see anyone that you know it really resonates with you, we are very open and we are looking for people to partner with us on this initiative to be able to bring them to life. So this is our target audience. We have students, learning institutions, families and communities. We have women and girls, international development partners. We have business entities and we have the government. So these are the people that we are sent to, for lack of a better word, these are the people we want to work with to be able to actualize everything that I've talked about since the beginning of this presentation. So our programs and initiatives, I've touched on a few of this, but I'm just going to run through access to funding for Black businesses, Arise Global Internship Program, Minority Tech Initiative, Passionomics Maryland, Legacy Financial Literacy Program, the Legacy Fame STEAM Program. We have the Legacy Coaching for Women, Farm to Wealth. For those who are, you know, passionate about agriculture, we have something working up in that area, and it's really going to be huge coming next year. And I mean, next year is the year for all of us, like Dr. Remy has been saying, the year where we get to bring all these partnerships together and make something really tangible out of it. So again, if you're a partner, if you're out there, you're seeing this, we're seeking your support. That is, you know, the reason why. And it's open to just older people, younger people, anyway, you can come in into the vision. We want to be able to, you know, share this with you. So I'm just going to touch on the IRS Global Internship Program. So the program is a platform designed to help young people harness the skills, talents towards greater productivity. We train our interns by giving them access to resources, opportunities that will help them develop new skills that are relevant to the workplace and business community. One thing that is really important and great about this program is it's really transparent. When I mean transparent, I mean you're going to be working with world-class people, world-class projects. There's no trying to hide things from you or trying to prevent you from accessing. No, we understand that it takes both generations. It takes more than one person to be able to actualize a vision. And we want to start with the young folk and bringing them on this internship program. Also, we will need sponsors, we need partners, because the vision is global and we want to be able to take it to the ends of the earth as, you know, we're permitted to. Okay, so this is the Legacy Colossus Coaching for Women. So to commemorate, like I said, Dr. Ernie will come later to touch on this on a major scale, but I'm just going to run through it really fast. To commemorate the 68th Independence Celebration of Nigeria, the Legacy Premier Foundation, which is our, you know, body, the mother of all we are doing right now, you know, launched this program, the Legacy Colossus Coaching Program, to empower women with the required skill and resources needed to advance their career. And this was birthed because over all over Africa, we see that women are still very limited to opportunities. You know, we don't find a lot of women in government. We don't find a lot of women occupying, you know, the echelon of leadership in so many organizations. And during independence, Dr. Emi had this vision to be able to train women, African women, but it's also open to women across the world to be able to, you know, reach out for those opportunities. Ourselves being, you know, one who has been able to break glass ceilings in her career and has been able to reach top positions. She wants to share, which is all what we are doing, is all about sharing this vision with more people and, you know, starting from my motherland, Nigeria. And that's what the Colossus program is all about. Also in line with the UN SDGs, we aim to strengthen our commitment towards gender equality and parity by ensuring that every woman who goes through the coaching program becomes more value-driven, goal-oriented, confident, and empowered. And that's the goal, really, you know, for women to come out of those shell spaces, to be able to occupy, to be able to own their power, to leave their elements, and to live out their dreams. And that's what the program is all about. So on a final note, I know I have to rush through this really fast so that we can, you know, save time. So the link, I'm going to leave this here for a while for those who are interested, for those programs I've mentioned, those programs I've touched on. If you're interested in supporting, I'm just going to, you know, move the slide back a bit so you can see some of those programs. If you know anyone you want to touch on, you want to support, or you just want to come in any capacity, you know, you can do that. So these are the programs once again. Access to funding, the internship program, tech. If you're into tech and you believe, oh, there are a few things you can partner with us on to help people, especially, you know, young Africans enter into this industry. we are well available for you. You know, we have a financial program, we have the farms wealth. If you're big on agri-tech in any form, even investment in agriculture, we are here, you know, waiting with open arms to receive you into, you know, this vision. And so I'm going to scroll back to the links. So these are the links to donate our, to support the course in any way possible that you can. And once again, I want to appreciate all of us, all the speakers from day one, particularly Dr. Remy, for making this possible. I mean, it's beyond my wildest imaginations to sit, I mean, amongst, you know, really great people. There are certain people I never thought I would see, you know, physically in any way, but it's been great. So thank you so much. And on this note, this is a contact address, contact information rather. The website is there, at www.legacypremier.org, our social media handles. And if you want to reach us via email, it's also there on the screen. So on this note, I'm going to hand over back to Kelsey. Thank you so much, Dr. Remy, for the opportunity to share. And I wish all of us a great time and a great life. Thank you so much.
Awesome. Thank you so much, Toby, for that fantastic presentation. I hope everyone, again, reaches out and learns more about the great work that the Legacy Premier Foundation is doing. And to keep us moving, I am now excited that we will be hearing remarks from our award chairs. And I know one of them is here today, Dr. Walini Akinbabe. We will now head over to you to give us remarks as we prepare to give out these amazing awards today.
He's not with us yet. What we are going to do is to keep on moving the needle and keep moving forward and allow other people to join accordingly. So I believe at this point, we would like to find out if the Honorable Aisha Breakboy is in the midst right now. If she is, we would take that segment. It's hard to know who is on. Okay. All right, I don't see her yet. So what I'm gonna do is, we're not gonna wait, we're just gonna keep moving so we can get to the point that we can be free and celebrate those awardees, because that's what this evening is all about. So we, Kelsey, okay, somebody, okay. What we did is there was an internship program that we started, and we have two people who graduated from it. And we want to be able to celebrate them. I'll let Toby talk about it very briefly. We want to be able to celebrate those two people. And when the state's attorney comes, she'll bring us remarks, and then we can all keep moving so we can enjoy our weekend. So Toby, talk about bringing the two fellows who were in the program that graduated successfully within just a few 5 minutes, and then we can just keep moving.
Thank you so much, Dr. Remy. So very quickly, if you saw my slide the last time, we had the Arise internship program, and we started officially this year, and we have two people on the program who have started with us for over the last 6 months, and it's been really an awesome experience. So today we want to celebrate them on a grand scale, because that's what we do around here, you know. We don't keep it to ourselves. We put it out there in the world, and we share these experiences. So I don't know if TK and TG. Okay, great. I'm just going to show them quickly. And I think Honorable Aisha is online too.
Okay, so if she's online, then we can bring her on.
Okay, yeah.
Hello, my dear Honorable Madam State Attorney. Great, thank you. Good to see you. Thank you so much for being part of this historical moment. And we were just awaiting you to bring some remarks and to help celebrate this young leaders who successfully completed their graduation process. Thank you.
Well, thank you so much, Dr. Dulia Lee. This is such an amazing feat. This is a wonderful occasion, and I'm so grateful to be able to spend time with you today. I want to thank not only Dr. Remy, as we affectionately call her, but also the Legacy Global Summit Committee and all of its partners for putting on an amazing event. You are true visionaries on the international stage, recognizing that the strength of Africa and the need to build partnerships that will strengthen not only Africa's economy, but the world's economy and our economy here also, not just in the United States, but specifically in Maryland and in Prince George's County, is at stake. And these relationships and partnerships will help everyone to grow. So I truly applaud the work that you are doing. And I believe that we must work together on all levels to make our communities and our world economically stronger. I also appreciate being able to come here and talk to you as the state's attorney. You know, my goal is not only to ensure that residents of our county are safe, but that they, are able to experience fairness, not just in the justice system, but all facets of life, including economic justice. So to that end, we've implemented several changes, such as changes in our bail policy, so that those who have who are poor or less able to afford a cash bond are not languishing in jail because they are not able to pay to be released. We've also looked at ways of expanding diversion, because what we understand is that when someone, gets a conviction, especially for felony, but really for any offense, that it impacts them economically, because it impacts their ability to get a job, to obtain education, to get credit, and other things that are extremely important in our society in order to achieve and grow wealth. So this, so what you're doing here is extremely important, because we understand that when people have access to wealth, access to economic opportunities, that they are less likely to commit criminal offenses, and therefore our communities are actually safer. And working with Africa, I think, is extremely important, because it opens new opportunities for economic growth and business opportunities. You know, experts predict that 5 of the 8 fastest growing economies are expected to be in Africa. So Africa is where the growth economically is. And by 2050, 1 in 4 global consumers will be African. And so now is the time, if we didn't know before, now is the time to really invest in relationships. So it's not just about creating more consumers, but growing business relationships with our brothers and sisters in Africa. So this is what I say, but Remy was on this a long time ago, before I think Congress knew, before presidents start really talking about Africa. Remy, I remember meeting her when I was much younger. She's the same age, but I was much younger. I remember her talking about this connection that we must have with Africa, and now we all have now caught up with Dr. Dooley. So it is really amazing that I'm in this position at this time as the state's attorney of the wealthiest, most affluent Black majority county in this country, because we have wealth here. We have the ability to build relationships. We have the ability to travel after the pandemic to strengthen those relationships. So I am really excited about all of the possibilities that we have before us. And I thank all of you that work with Legacy Global and the Legacy Global Summit to bring our young people into this conversation. They truly are our future, and their future will be brighter because of the work that you're putting in. So thank you so much again for having me. And I will put myself on mute, but I'll stay as long as I can so that I can, gain from all of you, all of the exciting and interesting things that you all are doing. So thank you so much for having me.
Kelsey?
Thank you so much to the Honorable State's Attorney, Ms. Aisha Bravefoy, for joining us. And I'm so excited, I think it speaks volumes to have you here, a part of this tremendous and significant event. And to keep things going, I think now we will move to the graduation ceremony. For her, I think it's very exciting. So excited to honor the young people, as we know, they are our future. And so now I think I will hand it over to Toby to do that presentation that he had started for us a little bit a while ago. So Toby, I will hand it over to you now so we can honor these great young people.
Thank you so much, Kelsey. So I'm just really gonna bring graduates quickly. So I think one of them is yet to join us, but here's Tammy. Tammy is one of our interns for this cohort of the RIS Global Internship Program. Tammy joined us a few months ago, and the experience has been great. Dr. Rabia, I think I'm going to have to invite the Honorable to do the honors.
Honorable Aisha Bravefoy, we would like you to do the honors of congratulating these two young people. One is here and ready, and yes, if you could do us the honors.
Thank you so much.
Well, what is the name of the graduate?
Okay, so his name is Tammy
Oluwa. You can say Tammy.
Tammy.
Tammy. Kai, yeah.
Okay. Tammy, congratulations on your graduation. This is so exciting. I know that there's a high expectations that we all have of you, and I know that you will rise to the occasion. You know, this is such a great and important partnership and summit. I don't know if you know how blessed you are to have people who pour into you all of their experience and knowledge. We did not have these relationships with Africa and the world when I grew up. I'm much older, but what I will say is that oftentimes, even though I am clearly African, the relationship with Africa and my generation wasn't there as strong as this relationship is now. And so you are in a great position, and this is a great time because we have technology that can connect us. We don't physically have to be there. We can be connected through technology, and we can build and grow relationships and partnerships around the world, and even business relationships just through the use of technology. So this is a great time to be young, and it's a great time to be thinking globally, and it's a great time to be doing business with Africa. So congratulations to you, and we expect a lot from you.
Thank you so much, Honorable. We appreciate it. I'm just going to ask, I think the second person is on now, so I'm just going to put him on board so he can. All right. Okay, so that's Thank God. His name is Thank God. So, yeah. Thank God.
Oh, I love it. Where is he? Oh, there we go. I see his picture. Okay. Well, thank God for you and your brilliance and your desire to be a part of really the global economy and to want to learn from those who really want to pour into you all of their lived experiences. We are really fortunate to have a Legacy Global Summit and Dr. Dulyali and all of her partners who really understand fully the opportunities that exist in Africa. And instead of exploiting those opportunities, what she wants us to do is grow those opportunities together, connect our diaspora, and all be able to benefit from the wealth that we know lies within our home continent. So congratulations on your graduation, and we again expect big things from you as well. So thank you so much.
Thank you.
Thank you so much. Thank you so much.
Thank you very much.
Tell me what you have anything to say quickly, very fast, because we're short on time. So Tammy, you go first.
All right, I just want to appreciate the Remy for this opportunity. It's really a great one. I really don't know. It's an opportunity anyone would really want to venture into or want to grab. And I thank God, I also thank Dr. Remy for the opportunity given to me.
Okay, thank God. You have it.
Okay, I want to appreciate Dr. Remy for the opportunity for creating such a great environment where you can work and your ideas are welcome for creating such an environment for us. Thank you so much, Dr. Remy. Thank you also, Mr. Toby, for your ideas. Thank you for always striving for excellence. Thank you so much. I've learned a lot from you. It was a period to learn, it was a period to serve, it was a period to grow, and I'm so happy that I was part of this internship. Thank you so much. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Thango. Thank you, Tammy, for making yourselves available. This was really a great experience with the both of you, and you know, thank you so much. I don't know if Dr. Remy wants to say a few words.
Absolutely. Thank you both so very much. I am super, super, super proud of you. Thank you for all the great things you've taught me. I'm a little smarter now. I'm thinking you're probably prouder of me than before. You taught me some techniques, and thank you. I see that the sky is the beginning. Always know that you will remain in our hearts, and if there's anything we can do to help you move that needle forward for greatness, we are here. Thank you both, and I know we will never depart from each other. The best is yet to come. And just be ready. Get ready, get ready. Thank you both very much. God bless you.
Thank you very much. Thank you very much, Dr. Remy.
Sure. And just to move her before the honors, we are really grateful for doing this for us. I mean, I don't know what to say so much, but thank you. Thank you. We are grateful. Thank you, Dr. Remy, for the platform. And we know it's going to be greater next year with everyone here, you know, listening to us and the whole world being part of this. You know, it can only get better. I mean, like we always say, it can only get better. So thank you so much. We're going to hand it over to Kelsey now. She takes us to the next section of the event.
Yes, thank you, Toby, so much for handling that section. And congratulations again to the graduates, Timmy. And thank God, I know you all are going to do fabulous things in your future. We're going to continue to follow you and the amazing leaders that you are. And of course, once again, a special, special thanks the Honorable State's Attorney Aisha Braveboy for joining us. We know how busy you are, but I know it's very special for the graduates to get a chance to hear from you. So a very special thank you. All right, so now we're going to move to the next part of the program. We're going to do the launching of the Legacy Colossus Coaching for Women, which I absolutely love and adore, from Dr. Remy Dulyali. She's going to lead us on this, and she's also going to talk about the launching of the Legacy Global Network. So lots of exciting things happening. Dr. Remy Dulyali, go ahead and lead us off on this. I'm very excited to hear about this. I know everyone in our audience is as well.
Thank you so much.
I'll hand it over to you.
Much, Kelsey. Thank you very much, Kelsey, for anchoring this. And thank you to Honorable Aisha Braveboy for your great work. We've been in the county forever, and you always have been consistently faithful with inclusion, intentional inclusion, creating a multicultural division where you attend to the needs of the different cultures. We want to say thank you to you. You are just a gem, and we will always celebrate you. We wish you many, many, many more successes. Just know that the best is yet to come, and we stand ready, we sit ready to support and to be there for you. And definitely we're going to call on you like we always do to see how all of these things that we're talking and speaking to the universe comes to fruition. Thank you, Honorable. So without further ado, I have a few minutes before you, and I know Toby will tell me time up, so I have to speak fast. So I'm no exception to the rules. So my birth nation, Nigeria, turned 60 this year. And as a result of that, we came up with a program that we wanted to use to enhance what had already been started called Legacy Colossus Coaching for Women. This coming year, 2021, okay, I need to go by the PowerPoint. Sorry, I was going to be. So the Legacy Colossus Coaching for Women is a program and a signature program from Legacy Premier Foundation. And the goal of that is to be able to help our women. The Colossus Coaching Program is a holistic coaching program, specially designed to equip women. There's something about women. We are so multitasking, and I have been privileged by the grace of God to be exposed in corporate setting. I've been vice president of a Fortune 5 banks, not to impress you, but to impress upon you where my passion pushes me and what drives me. A lot of people don't know the bus stop that I am. A lot of you have, you were with me on my journey as a starter. Some of my mentors are on the call. I hope I get to introduce some of you. Some of you have watched me grow. Some of you are watching me grow. But one thing for sure is, as women, we need to be equipped so that we can adjust to life-changing situations that are happening. So what it is, Toby, should I flow or am I going to get this life change? Okay, so we have shared the SDG goals that we're supporting, that is in line with what we're doing. And some of you might look at it. I see most of the goals are interwoven. And what we have tried to do is to bring our resources, our talents, our treasures, and our network, which all of you are part of, to see how can we make the world a better place? How can we create programs? How can we create things that will add value to lives in our own little way without pointing fingers and saying, oh, it's the government, it's Remy that's supposed to do this, it's that. What can we do in our space? So that's the goal. So this coaching colossus will give our women the opportunity to really be part of a program for 3 months. We're going to have 15 participants per quarter. We figure, oh, 15 people we can handle by the time I run to Dr. Mina Dempsey and say, please, I need 2 hours of your coaching time. I run to Kelsey, I run to Madam State Attorney and say, I need help with a few hours of your talent, gift, and treasure. We can make that happen. So we have 15 per quarter, which will start from January to March. And every quarter we'll have 15. For the total year, it will be 60. We figure we start small, and rather than just getting overwhelmed, because this is a leisure, intentional impact, there's no need to stress anybody about it. And we want to start with what we can deliver. And as we do what we can deliver, the Lord will send people who will be helpers, because this is not my personal assignment. This is an assignment that God has put in my heart, and I know He will provide for whatever He orders. Just like He ordered this conference, He provided. Everything else is history. So right now, we are expecting 15 participants. The application is ready. Thanks to Josephine, has become one of my mentees. So super proud of you on that intergenerational. But you were very, very helpful with this program creation. So 15 people per quarter, and winners will get up to 10,000 in investment, cash and time. And I'm saying that carefully, cash and time. There's so many professional help that we need. Sometimes it's not just the money. We just need somebody who cares, who wants to support our success journey. So we're hoping that that is what's going to be happening with that. And the goal is, within that 3 months, there's a curriculum that you go through. And I believe that's on the next slide. We will get people from existing registered business ready to move to the next level. This would not like be for like a super startup idea concept only. We want to be able to help people pivot. Women own business, and it must be of an African, the business has to be owned by an African in Africa. For this cohort, that's what we're focusing on. Remember, the genesis of it was to celebrate my birth country, where I was nurtured for 17 years before I got deposited to the United States of America for another 37 years. So that was just a give back to support that initiative. But we're going to replicate that here in America. So next slide, please. So right here, we have the program focus. The first idea is relationship building and stakeholder management. We're going to help people with that. Team leadership, pitching to pivot, emotional intelligence, personal and business branding, and how do you sustain this business? You can start something. It doesn't mean that you're going to be able to sustain it. And sometimes you need a network of people who can help you with the sustainability while you do your part. So that's what that program will focus on for 3 months. So some of you, I'll run to you and need your branding technique. I'll need you to maybe have them shadow you. So various of you, I'm coming to. My friends from the UAE, some of you are on the line now. Some of you too will be engaged to please help to make this businesses that get into it become successful. So once they go through the program in 3 months, there will be an opportunity for them to be bankable, like how I use my banking term. You've got to be bank ready. We got to be bankable. So we'll see how can we get them bankable. Criteria is I'm not going to be the one that picks whoever gets in. We have a committee for that. There's an application. When you get that application, I suggest you take the application and you apply. But please do not apply if you're not ready to move your life forward yet. And you see how I said yet? Because this is for serious people. This will be people investing their time out of no time just because they care. So the criteria needs to be that you want success for yourself with no excuses than anybody else. And once that's done, every quarter we get a 15, and then for the year 60. And we trust that as our work speaks, as we have modeled, we will also reach out to those who might be funders. But at the minimum list, we have network where we can have all these successfully trained women to be in front of venture capital, angel investors, or people who truly might want to sow a seed in their business. So we'll get them ready and have pitching competition. Our measure of success will be your success. This is not a money-making venture. This is just another way to ensure that we're paying it forward to whom much is given, much is expected. There's so much that the Lord has done. There's so much in a foreign land. How can you rise from a teller with an MBA to a vice president in a country where you know nobody and you have 4 stripes, black, female, Nigerian accent? That was my experience. But with all of that, the Lord still made me to be vice president. Even as of now, there are things we go through. So as I get older, as I see things, there are some unspoken expectations that is holding us women down. And my goal and my team's goal is to see how we demystify those things that create like an elephant in the room when they have no, they're toothless bulldogs, but they will stop to hold you and I bound because somebody you think has this, they really don't. Everybody is a work in progress. And those are the experiences I want to bring forth because I've owned my own businesses. I still have my businesses. It's important that we help to nurture those people. Like I said, my mentors, without them, where will I be? People I can run to when I say, oh, like the Dr. Doulas of this world and the late Bunny Darman, how can I live a life in America without those two people? Because they're always ready for me. They're ready. They tell me the truth, whether I want to hear it or not. If I say, oh, there's a hidden agenda. One of my mentors will say, life is full of agenda. Remy, deal with it. What is your own agenda? These are people, and I'm mentioning a few, I'll probably get in trouble, but those are the two that I know. May Bonnie Darman so rest in peace, and Dr. Dula, I'm sure he's listening somewhere, he's not on the webinar. So I just want to say thank you to my mentors, and what I've been given, I want to give back. And when I say I say my network, which all of you are, because you are my network. We are all together now, and let's help each other one life at a time. And this Legacy Colossus application will be available. I'm not part of the decisioning process. That's not my lane. But the team that's doing that, they will decide And of course, we're starting small, we'll make it bigger and better. So that is my spiel, and I'll get out of your way. So if anybody has a quick question for me, Toby, I don't know if I have time to take questions. If not, we can move on to the next. I don't know if there's time. Thank you all very much for listening. If you have questions, chat it up. If you don't, let's keep on moving. Over to you, Kelsey. Thank you for listening.
Remy, Dr. DLA, whatever people call you, because you're a woman of many names, because we all love you. I appreciate that so much. And like you said, it's giving back and nurturing that next generation. As she said, please reach out to her if you're interested in learning more. Such a fabulous program, and I couldn't think of anyone better to lead that great work. So very excited for that. All right, so we're going to get back to the program. I will check with you, Remy. Do we have any of our chairs on yet?
I will take on that responsibility at this point, because we're still expecting that Rosina will be able to help us get Akon to say a quick hello to us. So that will be our celebrity appearance. So rather than just holding and waiting, I want to be able to just take a moment to step in for them and just to say this experience has been very rewarding. It has been humbling. It's been a lot of work. But all in all, it's been worth it. Would we do it again? Yes, we will, and do much more. It's amazing where when you have an idea and it metamorphoses into an actionable document, actionable item, and especially when you know it will touch and change lives, that even makes you more excited. So what the committee have decided to do during this whole process was to come up with a legacy award ceremony, a way to, around the globe, people who have sown seeds one way or the other, and have made impact in the world, and maybe they have also remembered us as a company and have also stepped in to do one thing or the other just because they care, not because we matter, but they just care about us because they don't know us, but they just decided to care. So I'm gonna read some names. There's so many names, I know, don't get bored. Their names and they are justifiable. We even documented it. The team have their documentation on why some of these people are here, and most of you are deserving of our recognition, but because we can only do so many, which is still a whole lot for a starter, we are going to be able to say thank you to all of you at some point in the future. So we have the Legacy Visionary Leadership Award for Otumba Abimbola Ashiru. That's one of the awardees. I'm not sure who is on right now, but whoever is on, okay. We also have the Legacy Woman CEO of the Year to Ashi.
I'm on.
Oh, okay. All right. Otuba, we celebrate you, sir. Congratulations. So we have Otuba Ashiro, who is still on. Thank you. And then we have the Legacy Woman CEO of the Year to Ashi Zaveri. That's our sister from the UAE. I'm not sure. I think Ashi had another engagement. But Ashi is the woman of the year. We also have the Legacy Lifetime Humanitarian Award. That is to my mentor, someone that I've called my American father, Dr. James Dooler. I know he's not on the panel. He's listening in. He's on the phone. I want to publicly say thank you to Dr. Dooler. He's just, everybody needs a Dr. Dooler in their life. And Dr. Dooler, you are amazing. Mrs. Dooler, you're amazing. You have adopted me as your own, and I will forever make you proud. Thank you. We also have the Legacy Humanitarian Award to Rama Indimi. All of these people, you can Google their names and see what they are doing. These are merited unsung heroes. Some of them are. So we are saying thank you to them because they are doing a lot of work that maybe a lot of time we don't get to know. Again, I don't know that I have September Dorman. September, are you in the house now yet? September is the wife of late Bonnie Dorman, one of my key mentors. Bonnie was one of those, when this idea was conceived, Bonnie was like, Remy, you can do it. You know how you have those people that just say, you can do it. They just think you can do anything. And they will show you how to do it, and they will open their Rolodex to get you to how you can do it. So we started the process. He was slated to be a speaker in this conference before death decided to take him to heaven. So we miss you, Bonnie. I'm not sure if September was supposed to be here to receive this, but she had another important engagement. If she shows up later, you all will indulge me to please have her come and be recognized. We also have the Legacy Transformational Award. Otunba Olawanle Akinboboye. He is such a unique leader of our time, someone who conceptualizes so many great things, and he makes it happen, and he transforms lives, he transforms environment, a forest practitioner that we all have gotten to love. We have the Legacy Lifetime Achievement Award for Her Excellency, Dr. Arikana Chihombori-Kwa. One thing for sure is Dr. Kwa is always about results, about solutions, about her Africa, about how we need to take our Africa to the right places. So who better can get a lifetime? Because I know for the rest of her life, she will constantly do that. I don't see her stopping that. And then this is also my friend, Towanda Livingston, Legacy Influencer Award. Miss Livingston is so unique. She's a helpmate to everybody. She has solutions for everybody. She has a large heart to make things happen. Towanda, congratulations. We also have Legacy Innovation and Technology Award, Mr. Moses Onitilo. These are people who have taken their gift, their skills, not to the continent, they have taken it to everywhere to create possibilities in the area of fintech to help our underserved populace who are doing business. Mr. Onitilo, we salute you. Legacy Connector of the Year, Peggy Morris, my sister from another mother. I say that, I'm sure so many people on this call will say the same, because there's something unique about Peggy. Again, Peggy was, Dr. Dula referred me to Peggy. That's how good Dr. Dula is. He helps me find those who match what I need. He helps me pick the network. You say, oh, you're Nigerian. He helps me pick the right network. And the network he's picked, every one of them have not failed me. Dr. Dula, I say thank you. Peggy, I salute you, my sister. You are always there, the connector, always finding ways to connect and knowing that there are possibilities in everything that we do. We have the Legacy Female Business Leader Award. You all had our brilliant Mrs. Soyin Sonny earlier today, who, despite all her busy schedule, stopped and said hello and gave us the thoughts on finance and all the great things she talked about. Congratulations. We have also Mr. Mayu Modi, another great friend. We called him the COVID-19 Hero Award. This man made everything he can do possible to ensure that those who were not served were served. He was always finding ways to feed people, to clothe them, to do something to make them have a smile on their face. Mayor, we say congratulations to you. We have the Communicator of the Year Award, Mr. Victor Oladokun, who is unavoidably absent. There's another event in the Code of War that he's there. We have a Community Engager of the Year, Mr. Akindele Akiyemi. I know I saw him on the chat earlier. This is a man that continually engages the community, and he does it with all the passion. You can feel his passion even in his interaction and his talking. Mr. Akiyemi, we salute you, we thank you. I want to say also the Legislator of Distinction, Delegate Daryl Burns. You all had the privilege of hearing him speak yesterday. Not just only that, he wears so many hats, and he wears all those hats so beautifully. Congratulate you. We also have the Legislator of Distinction for our Congressman Anthony Brown, for Delegate Wanika Fisher, Councilman Will Jawando. I know they're not here, I'm going, so I don't keep boring you. These are legislature of distinction. These are people who roll their sleeves and know when their communities need help and how the community needs help. They take it beyond just doing their regular legislative work, just like our honorable Aisha Brave Boy. We have the Legacy Authentic Educator.
Yeah, I need a copy of it.
Olawe Omikunle.
Is that working?
Olawe Omikunle, you've heard of, can we mute whoever is not speaking, please, Toby, please? Olawe Omikunle is someone who has transformed educational space. She has shown her love for education in a way that you cannot but be passionate when you hear whatever she has to do in the space. So we keep going. The partner who have helped us with this conference is the voice of Africa. How can you thank people who just believe in a vision when there is not adequate provision? It can only be God that will send such people who believe in something you don't see. I know we have faith. We have faith in God, not in man, but they had faith in us. Voice of Africa, we celebrate you, we salute you, we thank you, we say the best is yet to come. We are just beginning. Another media partner, Pleasures Magazine. Thank you, Pleasures Magazine. We cannot thank you all enough. You constantly point to us, share our brand, promote us. Business Connector Award, Dr. Wendy Risley. I'm not sure if you get that. Dr. Risley, who cares? The whole of yesterday and started this morning too. A good friend, someone that I can call my sister from another mother, Dr. Wendy Risley, with whom we celebrate. We also have the Diplomat of the Year. The Rwanda ambassador was unavoidably be absent because of another important work of duty, which of course has been but he didn't just say she had a call. She replaced herself with the highest officer in her embassy. Just say that I need Mr. Lawrence to be and represent. So we salute Madam Ambassador. We are coming at you. When we say this coming, we're coming. We have the next steps to do. And Mr. Lawrence had already promised that the door is wide open and we're going to walk the door and make sure we make impact. The Visionary of the Year Award, Dr. Richard Miles Sr. If you've heard of MFL, you know that's the Minor Football League. That's someone who was an NFL player who have now started a replica of NFL, but calling it Minor Football League. The footprint is all over Africa, so if you're interested, you should let us know. Open to talking and see how we can get this to Africa and some other parts of Africa. Legacy Missionary Award, Bishop Hutton, we thank you for all that you do, making the space available, supporting, helping us when we go and feed the homeless, doing everything we can do to make little businesses thrive. We say thank you. Authentic Global Diaspora, that's some Kamalafe from Ireland. Tom is so creative that if you're not an African and you're there, you will know about Africa. She's passionate and committed to her Africa. So we say thank you. Legacy Impact Power Driver, Honorable Engineer Dale Maman. I don't know if he's in the house. We salute you. Legacy Impact Collaborator and also Legacy Distinction, Legislator of Distinction. This is Honorable Aisha Braidful. I tried to look for words, and when I was describing her to the committee, and they also were doing their research, they're like, this is just somebody that's uniquely brilliant and has a heart for impact and for collaboration. So we salute you, Madam Honorable Aisha Braidful, and keep up the good work. Is yet to come, and we are here to support you. Legacy Influencer Award, Honorable Idris Muhammad. Legacy Emerging Leader Award, Rolake Akikube Filani. Legacy Visionary Diplomat Award, we have Ambassador Innocent Iwejo. I don't know if he's on, I know he's accepted. We have ambassadors, we have people in the embassies who just create access and make things painless. Especially when you're nobody, because people like to know that you're somebody, even though you know you are somebody, but when they don't know you, they think you're nobody. But this man is consistently faithful and making sure that he does what he needs to do. Community Inclusion Leadership Award. Stephen McAdams is the executive director for the community initiatives for the state of Maryland under Governor Hogan. Stephen, you wouldn't know what party or where he belongs. He supports the whole community and he engages all of us and he loves us. Legacy Lifetime Achievement Award. PLO Lumumba is unavoidably absent. He has been at some of our events before now. That's what he's getting. Legacy Media Partner Award, Mr. Alaba, you know, these are media luminary, people who have done great work in the media world. Thank you. Legacy Serial Entrepreneur of Impact, Dipo Adesina. You know, Dipo has been all over the place, impacting lives, creating entities, sharing his success stories with all of us. Legacy Business Development Support Award, Roshanda Johnson, International Development Award, Gregory Simpkins, Global Trade Influencer Award, that is Ms. Janine Scott. We know Ms. Scott is someone that has been around this community forever, and she's so consistently loving and caring and cherishes every opportunity she has to serve. Thank you, Ms. Scott. I'm praying that we hear some good news very soon so we can continue this conversation on a higher note. We also want to say Nicole Woods, professional award. Nicole Woods is so professional with what she does that she will ensure that we get engaged when we need to get engaged. Nobody looks and sidelines anybody. Alan Bird is a finance innovator. Alan had done businesses in so many nations and still doing businesses, but so creative. My sister, my friend, Dr. Minna Dempsey, Global Influencer Award. This is a lady that is, she always downplays and says, oh, policies and policy, that she's not in the trade space. Who could hear her analyze the policies behind those trade and not listen? I mean, I was sitting glued to my chair this morning when she was getting us through her session. I'm like, now I know why I'm proud of her more than ever. She will talk sense into the heads of people. So she's a Global Influencer Award awardee. Youth Innovator Award, Dayo Israel. I don't know if he was able to come back on. We know that he is so powerful, especially around the globe, because prior to his role now, he was one of those vocal young leaders who, he doesn't just talk, he does, and he creates innovations. And we have the Creative Entrepreneur Award. Rosina, my sister, the wife of Akon. I mean, Rosina is a woman of many paths. She is so firebrand that she is confident. You see her and she just gravitates towards you without wearing any ego in her space. She just believes that the world is free and let's move. And Rosina, we know that you're creative, your entrepreneurship has inspired a whole lot of people. We say thank you. I know this woman is in the house, my friend, Sheikha Abdullah. You probably is way past your bedtime. I know that because you're in the UAE. That's 9 hours, but you stayed on. You stayed on just to be part of this. We celebrate you, Sheikha. And we know Ajman is going to be hearing from us, and there are so many follow-ups that we're gonna do. Congratulations for being the woman of impact, and which is who you are, and keep up that great work. Legacy Distinguished Diplomat Award, Ambassador Bankole Adeoye. I know he's joining. I can't see all of you, but I know he's joining from the part of the world that he's in. These are people who make diplomacy fun. These are people who make everything that they do about service good. They don't need to know you. They just know of your competency and your intellect, and they act and treat you like a human being. Ambassador Adeoye, I hope that the best is yet to come and that we see you in other greater places, because you deserve to serve us more because you have the heart of service. Legacy Educator of Distinction Award, Dr. Hadi Washington. Dr. Hadi Washington has been an educator forever, even though she says she's retired, but she's not tired. Constantly educating, serving, creating ways to educate people. We salute you. Legacy Relationship Builder Award, Bishop Dr. Patrick Kidwell. I think I've seen you all day on the screen. Not sure how you created the time, but I want to salute you and say thank you for being that builder, that relationship builder, and you build it in all areas. Congratulations. Legacy Global Transformation and Influencer Award. Ambassador Michael Battle. I'm not sure if he's able to make it. We all know there's still some dangling information that we need to sort out here in America, but Ambassador Battle, we celebrate you. We also have the Legacy Community Mobilizer Award. Umu Bar. Congratulations, my sister. Continue to mobilize, because when we are all getting to be at the table and understanding what is at stake when we're not at the table, then we will get involved. Thank you for being a mobilizer, and don't get tired, because the best is yet to come for all of us. The Emerging Leader Award goes to Samuel. Samuel is an emerging leader that just stands out, who is always creative in his space. Philanthropic and Leadership Award to Dr. Oluremi Bukweju, a fine obstetrician who is also a philanthropist. He supports everything that is good. He supports everyone that's going forward. He doesn't need to know who you are. He just supports. He believes that there's a better way to do things, and he always supports people. When we were talking about intergenerational, he's one of those who have displayed the importance of the intergenerational. He does not look at age. He constantly serves and serves forward. We also have the Leadership Award to Dr. Fola Oluwenhimi, who also is an astute medical practitioner who is always ready to serve, who also shows his leadership everywhere and looking for ways to create ecosystem in the health setting whereby we all can build together. We have our global media partner, Ms. Jules Lavallee. How do I say thank you to Jules, who is always one of our advocates and always looking for ways to push what we are doing forward? And not just us, I see you're consistent with the people that you do it for. I'm saving one for the last because I don't know if the person will be receiving it or if they will have a representation. We have a Legacy Distinction Award for Benjamin Cardin. They also were in support of all this. Media partner, Crystal Glenn. When Legacy Premier Foundation was just trying to figure out how do we put our graphics together, how do we know our left from our right, Crystal raised her hand and said, I'm going to do everything within my power. And Krista does that for everybody. I found that out. So it's not about what people have done for us. It's what they are doing that maybe is not noticeable that we have noticed. Krista, congratulations. Legacy Influencer Award, Yolanda Bryson Durant. This is my childhood friend. I call it childhood friend. Someone that we played together, and we played big. I don't know if Yolanda is on the line. In the Bank of America days, in our 20s, we were rocking that company. And there were three of us, Yolanda, myself, and Daphne Tate. We were unstoppable. And I see that you're still unstoppable, my sister. In your corporate setting, I decided to go in the entrepreneurial lane, but still love you all. And thank you for always being a supporter and showing up and making us proud, even as a senior vice president. There's also a Legacy Innovator Award for Ayodele Juyile, who is also my son. And I know you wonder, this is a son who creates tech initiatives to be able to support other young people, which he doesn't have to do. He works for Microsoft, but he has the heart of giving back through text giving. And he's used that to go and complete a technology hub in Ondo State. And he's doing many more things, always saying he wants to bring brown and black kids to know about technology, always reaching out to see how do I help to make people, more people come into technology. So Ayodele, we salute you. We need you to do many, many more. Another great young mentee of mine is Vanessa Adebayo, Legacy Social Development Award. Vanessa started something revolutionary, mental health, someone who just decided to create solutions to help other people find what they might not have found as a problem. And she has blossomed, I watch her blossom into that leader that is unstoppable. So Vanessa, we salute you, Legacy Social Development. We know the best is yet to come. We see your hand all over the wall, how you're making your moves and doing your impact. I wanna say you've got God behind you and we are behind you. Legacy Leadership Development Award. Victory Oluwasegun was was the moderator for that panel that was very firebrand. That was my favorite panel, if I may confess to the public. The intergenerational panel was really one of my favorite. So Vitri is a leadership development person. He has helped so many mentees, young people, even including my son, through his opening his business for everybody. They found out their passion. So remember, that is what is going on. We also have this Brand Master Award to Mr. Toby Adesina. If you're looking about looking at a brand master, somebody who can put things together, who can be creative and hardworking, you need to not look further. And I did my little research. This is consistent with what he does. Legacy Emerging Leadership Award. Aldo Maikori, we know you're always there in New York grinding, making us proud as Africans and also as Americans. You're always there making, showing your leadership and creating news for people to see positivity about the Africa that we love. Legacy Impact Award. Kemi Ajumobi is someone who has publicly said, I love the women because the women are just, I just like to support them. She means that. She supports them intentionally to create results, to create an end game that all of us can say, yes, we're proud of. We have Ms. Kelsey Nicole Nelson. I know she's not aware of this. This is a surprise. I don't even know if you know. Legacy Impact Award. Kelsey is just one of those people that's ready to serve every community. She is ready to serve the youth, the old, which I call myself, and those who are in the middle. She's forever ready. She has demonstrated that power of knowing how to relate intergenerationally. We also have the Legacy Transformational Leadership Award for Ambassador Muchanga, who was unavoidably absent today. And the last but not the least, we have Ms. Denise Cortez, Legacy Emerging Leader of Excellence Award. Thank you all very much. I don't think I missed anybody. You will get your certificates. You will get your graphics that we're showing you. All of that will be emailed to you. So you could celebrate yourself. We celebrate you. And we also will be in touch with each and every one of you. Do not be a stranger. Always know that at Legacy Premier Foundation, we stand ready to help, to do whatever we can do to add value. As long as it's a movement that is going to make impact, we are there. If it's not, we can create impact, but if that's not interesting to us, we want to make a difference. That's our goal. So as I continue to talk, Nicole, I'm done with the awards ceremony. I don't know if Akon is here that so we can get that celebrity appearance. I'm going to ask Rosina. Oh, yeah, yeah. Oh, my God. Rosina was asking a question. I didn't get to see it. Yes, yes, yes. Oh, yeah. So we might get a quick hello, a quick shout out from Akon. That is when that's our next step, celebrity appearance. So as soon as we get a quick hello and we also let him know that we are looking forward to him and my sister Rosina partnering with us, we can continue to celebrate. I'll do the closing remarks. And we can let you all go enjoy your day. We're still within time frame, so please bear with us. Hang in there. So I'm going to wait and see what I get back to see if Akon can say hello. Thanks to Kemi for going there, because I for bringing that conversation up. That was a good leading. So I'm waiting for Rosina. So as I wait, two things I can do as I wait, actually. If I don't hear, I don't want to let us pass any time that we're supposed to pass. Some of you have been with us the whole time. Oh, did I miss somebody? Okay. Okay, thank you. Hold on. Oh, yes. Oh, my goodness. It was an oversight. Miss Thelma Akiyo is one of our D's. I am so sorry. Oh, my God, my glasses better be working. Ms. Thelma Akiyo is the legacy impact builder. And she has built impact in the area of finance. Before you can build financial impact, you have to be able to create a system where you get people ready to take advantage of the impact. So Thelma, my apologies. You are the one with the Legacy Impact Award. Thank you so much for all that you do. Thank you for chatting me up there. I don't know if I'm missing anybody that's talking to us as we go ahead and await Mr. Akon to say hello. As we do the awaiting of Akon, I want to do my closing remarks, if Kelsey would permit me to do that. So at least when Akon comes, we can say hello. We have some music. to play and to just keep on the conversation. Legacy Global Network is here to stay. So definitely you will be hearing from us, right, at the conference. How do you say thank you? How do you close an initiative that was long desired, that you never knew that could happen the way it's happening? I knew it would happen, I just didn't know when, but that it could happen in this manner, that everybody have sown into this to make it a success, because we've gotten your feedback, and that's why we're calling it a success. But the success for me will be measured next year or along the year when all of you are saying, guess what, we have funding, guess what, we have partnerships here, we have that, we have this, we have that. That's when success will be for me. But in the interim, I want to be able to say thank you to all of you. So I'm going to read my closing remarks, which is a thoughtful one that was designed for you all to feel the heart of gratitude. My heart is full of gratitude to God for his grace and help towards the success of this program. Wait a minute, is the deputy governor still on? I was holding to do his last, the deputy governor of Kwara State. I wanted us to be able to highlight him personally. Please, can you answer? Does anybody know? Okay. If it's not, I'm not sure if Mrs. Thomas is on the line. We also have one of the awardees. I was waiting to get the deputy governor so he can receive it for the governor. So the governor of Kwara State has distinguished himself as the gender diversity and youth empowerment governor, and that caught our attention. And the deputy governor was part of the panel. Kwara is open for business, thankfully, and we want to honor him with the Legacy Global Champion for Gender Diversity and Youth Empowerment, His Excellency Abdul Rahman Abdul Razak, the governor of Kwara State. We salute you, sir. We hear the good work, we see the good work. We want to partner with you and thank you for sending a representation, and we know that we are going to connect very soon. Without further ado, my heart is full of gratitude to God for his grace and help towards the success of this program. It is such an honor to have great people as guests, sponsors, partners, and team members for Legacy Global Summit 2020. I respect your sacrifices, especially my family, my beloved husband, and children. I salute and thank you for your relentless support ever since I have been engaged and married to my husband. It is without any doubt that I do love to say that each session was incredibly insightful and a call to action. I believe that every attendee got great value in exchange for their time and resources. And I wanted to say thank you to all of the attendees, the speakers, partners, sponsors, moderators, compares, and team members. This is not just a summit, it is the global network of economic bridge builders willing to collaborate and partner with each other towards building a sustainable economy, not just in Africa, but in our respective nations. Therefore, we are inviting everyone to be a part of this global movement for economic growth and development, the Legacy Global Summit. As I close, I want to leave us with a quote from one of my favorite books, Proverbs 22:29, in the New Living Translation. Do you see someone skilled in their work? They will serve before kings. They will not serve before officials of low rank. And my personal quote, examine your Rolodex of life, and you will be amazed to see the snapshot of your life journey. That is a quote from me, Remy Duyele. Once again, thank you for giving your time and resources. I look forward to seeing you next year with great results and testimonials with productivity. Thank you and God bless. Please continue to stay safe and no stopping. The best is yet to come. We thank Cyber CMC and everyone who have been part of this. Thank you all very much. We love you. We appreciate you. And we will bring our celebrity appearance as we also enjoy some music in the interim. So thank you all very much. Stay blessed. I appreciate you all. The best is yet to come. That's what I keep hearing in my spirit. Let's get the best out. This is the time. It's in the Bible. It's a word in the Bible. The best is yet to come. Whatever your faith is, please don't be offended by what I express. Whatever your faith is, I know the best is yet to come. We are together and no more stopping. Shika, I say thank you to you. Inshallah, we are in the UAE 2021 by the grace of God. That is where the
welcome to all
for this conference. Oh, there you are. I didn't know if you were still on. That is the plan.
Welcome to all of you. Welcome to all.
Thank you. Thank you so much. We appreciate you and so many of you. Thank you all very much. We're waiting for Akon. Let's get some music. Let's move our bodies.
Okay.
And just, hey, Bishop, we thank you all. And you can come on. All of our bodies, please. Maybe zoom in and let's say hello to you so we can get a screenshot. If you're an awardee, please, and you're here, if you don't mind while we're waiting, can you just zoom in and we can do a screenshot of you?
So how do you see that?
There you go. All right. Appreciate you. Dr. Patrick Kidwell. Thank you, Honorable Aisha Braidboy. Blessings to all of you. Shika, my sister now. You're amazing. Thank you for staying up this late, 9 hours. Oh my God.
Wow.
It's like amazing. You are amazing. You touch my heart. Thank you. Mr. Ayinola, God bless you. David Smith, my brother from another mother. Thank you. I appreciate you all. Please keep everybody on so I can say my special thank you as we await Rosina to see what Akon has in stock for us. Anybody else that is on? Anyone, we thank you all very much. God bless you. I know some of us don't wear camera because I see your names, but I know some of us don't want to come. Like, that's all good. It's okay. Dubai, here we come. UAE, here we come. That will be next year, God willing. We will be there and you will hear details. So if it tickles your fancy when you hear the details, jump on board. Don't wait till the last minute. We are not going with everybody. We have a specific goal, and we will accomplish that goal. So if you hear the announcement and it's of interest to you, Miss Kamalafe all the way from Ireland. Madam, I salute you. Miss Peggy Morris, thank you. Kemi Ajimobi, thank you. Kelly Nicole Nelson, I adore you, my sister. David Smith, I already saw you. Shout out, Honorable Aisha Braidboy, Dr. Patra Shika, Mr. Alaba, you know, Mr. Akindele Akiyemi, thank you so much. God bless you. Dr. Kapoor Kavita, my partner from another mother. You are amazing. Thank you. Our work has just begun. You know it, right? All the follow-ups we've been desiring is here to stay. Let's get ready. Dr. Oluwadimi, I know you are answering to the call of duty with your patients. Thank you. I know you hear us. Thank you so much. Thank all you. Of you. I'm so excited. Tawanda Livingston. Oh my God. You guys are just so amazing. You're adorable. What will make this so, so joyful is if we convert this to results and we can point and say these are lives that we've touched in our own special way and be our brother's keeper and not be stoppers of God's glory. Guess what? Nobody can stop God's glory. Nobody. They can try, but they won't succeed. So if you just align with those who are moving things forward, your own things will move forward. Thank you, my sisters and brothers. I am excited. Let me check my messages. Toby, I don't know if you want to give us some music so we can move our bodies as we wait for Akon. We're looking to getting from, because he has a meeting from what we're called. Thank you from Quara. Okay, let's read some of the chat box. Oh, yeah, I should be thanking all of you. There's no event without you. My team and I would have just been talking to ourselves. By now, we'll be tired of ourselves. So we thank you all very much. God bless you. All of you have just made this 2 days a success. And I'm thankful that as Americans, I want to just change over. As Americans, Nigerian Americans, America supported us. We did not just get citations from the senators. We got it from the Congress, from the federal, state, and the county. What else could we ask for? That is an endorsement of what Legacy Premier Foundation is about. We got a citation from Senator Benjamin Cardin. We got citation from Senator Chris Van Hollen. We got citation from Congressman Anthony Brown, from the governor of Maryland. We got a letter welcoming everybody. We got citation from the Secretary of State. He also came in person to welcome our people. Not only did he write a letter, we got citation and proclamation from our own very honorable Aisha Brave Boy. This is what the world is talking about. We've got our American backing. I'm a Nigerian American. I have my Nigerian backing because we have the likes of Otsumba Akinboboye. We have the likes of Otsumba Ashiru, who we know are our gateway to what we need to do, and many more that I have not mentioned their names. Sheikha, we are ready for Ajman. We're ready for the UAE. We're ready to make impact, and together we are going to do it. Thank you all very much. God's blessings will continue to flow in your lives. And as you make things happen, people, God will make it happen for you. Trust me. It will just be a matter of when. Keep doing good. Avoid the distractions. Distractions won't get you anywhere. Stay focused. Staying focused will cost you money. It will cost you time. It will cost you loneliness. But stay focused and use God as your anchor. And let him know your desires. He will never fail. He has never failed anyone that I know. Now I'm preaching, but I'm also a deaconess in my church. So I don't want to turn this to a church. I'm just trying to express my joy. I don't know how better to express my joy without sharing my faith. So please forgive me if I'm being a little bit overbearing, but I'm just thanking the Almighty Allah. Chika can relate to that, and all of us, the Allah has made today possible. And all of you that joined us from different parts of the world, staying late at 2 a.m., 3 a.m. just to be here, wow. I don't need to hear anything else from you again, Chika. I know you're ready for us in the UAE. That's all. We are ready. Thank you. And I know your team is ready. Thank you all very much. And Toby, can you give us, it's impossible for you to get off. He's on a conference call. Okay, let's keep playing music. Toby, thank you all very much. Kelsey, any closing parting words for us so that those who want to hang around can hang around as we all move our bodies and do our exercises?
Yeah, I'm so excited to get the party started as we wait for Akon, which is truly an honor and a joy to be part of this event. A special thank you to you all for having me a part of this wonderful event. And just so many incredible, inspiring stories. And I hope we all keep connected and just continue to just dialogue and keep having these conversations. These conversations don't end. We're going to continue to have them. As Remy said, we're excited for the UAE in the upcoming years. And to all the award winners, just keep being rock stars.
Give me freedom, give me fire, give me reason. Hold on,
take me high, be the champion, take the field down. Unify us, make us feel proud. In the streets, our heads are lifting as we lose our inhibition. Celebration, every nation, all around.